So in this video, we're going to look at introduce you to the concept of the gradient vector. Now, the gradient vector really comes from the given that we have some function f of x, y. Okay, so you're given some function f of x, y. And from this, if you generate what's called the gradient vector, it's basically the gradient of f. Okay, and its definition is it is basically the vector partial, I mean, what results is partial f by x, partial f by y, and basically that's your gradient vector. Now, you have to keep in mind that this thing here, some basics, this thing here is, this is referred to as nabla, okay, or the grad. It's also called grad. Call it grad. I mean, the calculation gradient short, grad. Okay, so, but this operator, nabla, is in fact, it's an operator. So it's a vector, in fact, and it's partial by partial x, partial by partial y, and in the case of the third dimension, partial by partial z. But let's stick to two dimensions for the time being. So you have partial by partial x and partial by partial y. Now, when you take this and multiply it by this scalar function here, f, okay, so as we've done here, as you can see, these two are being multiplied. So that's a scalar quantity that multiplies into a vector, which means that each of these is multiplied by f, in other words. So that's how these f's occur here. So you end up with the partial fx and partial fy. So basically you go from a surface, I mean a function that represents a surface, for instance f of xy, and when you take the gradient, the result is a vector, in fact. Okay. Now this can, of course, as I said, it can be easily extended to three dimensions. So if if we have fxyz, then the grad f is simply partial fx, partial fy, and partial f. So what I'm going to look at as an example is, in fact, I'll look at a three-dimensional case so that you can see that this does work for 3D as well. So basically, it's as simple as saying that grad f, okay, is just the x derivative of this, which is 2x plus 2y, the y derivative, which is 2x, and the z derivative, which is 2z. So it's this vector. It's as easy as that. Just as simple as that. Just take the function f of x, y, z, differentiated with respect to x, that's your x component, differentiated with respect to y, that's your y component, and differentiated with respect to z, it's your z component. Just to be clear, there's the other notation in case you are more comfortable using this notation. It's just going to be 2x j plus 2zk. So those are the two different notations, they're both equal.